everyone, it's Kim Dao here. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a really big Japanese makeup and skincare haul. It's been a really long time since I've done a Japanese makeup and skincare haul because I was kind of focusing a lot more on Korean makeup last year. But this year when I went back to Japan, I picked up quite a lot of new makeup and skincare that I haven't really tried out yet. So I'm going to be showing you guys some of the items in this video. I'll be trying out some of the makeup items as well. So hopefully you enjoy this video. Just before I start this video, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet to keep up to date on all my new videos. Also check out my vlog channel because I have a lot of Japan vlogs on there. I'm also uploading a lot of old Japan vlogs which I never uploaded when I lived in Japan. And also you see some extra fun videos on there from time to time. First item I'm going to show you guys is a cushion. Now I got this in its demo in Japan. It sells makeup, accessories, but their makeup items, they usually have collaborations with Disney, Pokemon, Sailor Moon, and a lot more different ones. So they did a Pokemon collaboration last year, and I actually made a video with the collaboration items on my channel, so I'll link that video down below. Recently they came out with a Christmas collection for the packaging of the Misha Magic Cushion Moisture. And I haven't tried any cushions from Misha yet. I'm gonna open this one up now to try with you guys because I feel that if I don't, I'll never get to show you guys what it's like. The cushion actually feels a lot lighter than a normal cushion. This is the packaging I ended up choosing. It's the Alolan Vulpix version, which is absolutely adorable. Because it is a Christmas collection, they did have a Pikachu version as well with like Santa hats and stuff, but I felt that after Christmas, it'll be a bit weird to carry around a Christmas item, so I didn't want to get that one. The puff has little Vulpixes on it. Isn't that cute? It actually feels really, really soft, guys. Like, a lot softer than the usual makeup puffs. It's just like your standard cushion, and let's open this up. The cushion I got in number 23, which is a darker shade. Let's just do this first impression swatch. But the colour looks like it blends in pretty well. Guys, the coverage is good. To be honest, I've tried out Misha makeup before, and I wasn't really a huge fan, but this is good. I'm gonna use a little bit of this on my face. Maybe I'll just do it like here, maybe around here. Just by pressing it down a little bit, you get quite a lot of product on it. I already have foundation on my nose though, so it might look a bit cakey, but let's see. I actually really like this. It's really moisturizing and the coverage is really good. To be honest, I didn't have many expectations because this was only $10 for this item as well. Not bad, guys. Definitely recommend that. Speaking of Pokemon items, I also have another one. And this is a Pokemon face pack. Now, I got this when I went to Village Vanguard. And the reason why I got it is the mask itself is actually a Pikachu mask, which will look very creepy, but I thought it would be really fun to try out for a video. So I might do like another try on skincare video for Japanese skincare. So make sure you guys check that video when it comes out a bit later. Okay guys, so the next few items I am super, super, super excited to show you guys. I got a whole bunch of Sailor Moon items, guys. Look at all this. I've loved Sailor Moon ever since I was a little kid, and Sailor Moon came out with a lot of new makeup products. I actually haven't really been able to find a lot of them because they've been selling out, but I got a bunch of these items from YesStyle. So I'll link everything down below if you guys want to check out these items for yourself. But let's start with opening up these makeup items. I'm so excited. This one here is something I've been wanting to try out for so long. This is the Rainbow Moon Chalice Cheek. I saw this when I was in Hong Kong, but it was sold out everywhere. So when I saw it on YesStyle, I was like, I need to have this. Oh, wow. Look how gorgeous it is. Oh, I love this so much. I didn't even want to use this because of how pretty it is. I feel like I just want to keep this in the back and never ever use it. But because I promised you guys I'm going to actually use the items, let's do it. This is a blush. It's a very light pink color. Let me swatch with my fingers. Ooh, it's quite soft. I don't know if you guys can see it properly, but it's a super light pink color. I kind of wished it was a bit more darker in color. I mean, I'm already wearing some makeup, but maybe can provide a little bit of highlight if I apply just above. To be honest, I don't think it made much of a difference. I mean, the packaging is absolutely gorgeous. I just really wish that the color was different, but it looks like you can actually take it out and then replace it. And maybe you can put like a small brush inside. Because you can take it out, I feel that I can DIY a blush and maybe make a different color. But for now, I'm just gonna appreciate the packaging because it's so beautiful. Next item I got is the Miracle Romance Pretty Guardians Color Powder. Now, I saw this online and immediately I wanted to get it. So the packaging is meant to be like the silver crystal in Sailor Moon, and it's got those colorful beads inside. Now, I've used products with the beads before and I actually really like it. It's kind of like a loose powder to give you that translucent shimmery glow when you apply it on your face, and it's a great way to finish off your makeup to give you that dewy look. I'm gonna try and set my makeup with this powder and let's see how that goes. I'm just gonna use my powder brush to go in. I quite like it. The packaging is gorgeous and it does its job. Next is the Miracle Romance Shining Moon Powder Flat Style. Oh, I just love this packaging. It's just so pretty. So this looks like it's a powder and it's got a highlighter at the top and it's got little stars and a luna, also a moon at the bottom. The powder itself, I'm kind of confused on how to use it. It looks like the top part is a highlighter, the middle part is the face powder, and then the bottom could be used as a bronzer. But putting it all together like this, it kind of confuses me. So let's just get that. The problem is I've already got highlighter on my face and powder, so I'm just caking my face even more. I mean, I can see how this would work. It's not very pigmented. So I guess I can use it as a normal face powder with a brush. Using a puff, it doesn't really pick up much of the product, but if I use a brush, it would be a lot better, I think. To be honest, I think this one is just average. Next item I got is the Miracle Romance Cosmic Heart Cheek Flat Style. Packaging, guys, packaging. Just all of these products. Ooh, okay. So it's kind of a mixture between a rose and a light pink color. Let's swatch it. Pigmentation wise, it's just average. It's not like the greatest, but let me just try and swatch that color. That is the color you get. So it is quite light, which I'm really surprised about because usually Japanese blushes are very pigmented. Oh, actually, when you apply it on your cheeks, it shows up a lot more. Probably have way too much blush on now. I'm such a cake face. I actually really like this. So on your hand, it doesn't look like much, but when you actually apply it on your face, looks good. Next, I got the Miracle Romance Makeup Moisture Rouge 2017. So this one only just came out last year. This is a transformation pen that Sailor Moon uses. Let me swatch that. I'll swatch it right here. Oh, it's very moisturizing and it's very pink. I really like this. I feel that I can use this. Oh wow, it stains. Guys, I'm trying to like blend it out and it's actually staining my hand. So that's really good. It's a good lipstick, guys. Last two Sailor Moon items I got are brushes. Woo! The first one is the Moon Stick. Oh, I'm so happy with this one. It's gorgeous. And then this one here is the Spiral Moon Rod. Look at how adorable they look. To be honest, they're not exactly the best quality, but they're great for traveling because you can just carry them around like this and you don't have to worry about them getting damaged. But these would be great for like blushes, bronzers, highlighters, even like to powder your face for traveling. That is all the makeup items I bought, guys. I am so excited and I cannot wait to use them more often. Now, I got some skincare items I got from Don Quixote. Now, these are all wrapped up because I got them all tax-free. Now, to get tax-free in Japan, it depends on the store. Some stores, they require you to spend over $30. Some stores require you to spend $50 or $100. It really depends, so you have to check with the store first. Tax-free in Japan just means that you don't pay the tax on the items, and that is 8% off your shopping. So to get tax-free, you need to show your passport with a tourist visa inside. And usually, they will wrap up your items like this and tell you to don't open it until you leave Japan. First item I got is a Beauty Clear Powder from Cannibal. Now, I've shown these in my best Japanese skincare products video, which I'll link down below. You can check that out. And this is amazing for washing your face, especially when you travel. It's just a little tiny container like this big, and all you need is a little bit of water, and it just cleanses your face. It's amazing, so I definitely recommend this. And then I got the Mentholatum Medicated Lipstick. Now, I've used this before. In Japan, I feel like my lips get super dry. I don't know why, maybe it's the air, but when I was in Korea, my lips weren't that dry. In Japan though, definitely my lips felt a lot more dry and they would start cracking and flaking and I start picking my lips, which is kind of gross. So I'd use this chapstick on my lips and it works wonders, guys. And this is less than a dollar for this item. Next, I got the Tour Nuit Insulfurant Bond from Sana, and I've used this in the past, and it's a really good item. It's very gentle on your skin. So I'm going to try and change my skincare routine around and try some new Japanese products. So hopefully this will work really well, and I will do another video on Japanese skincare later once I get a Japanese skincare routine that actually works really well. I've used this a few years ago and I really like it because it's really gentle on your skin. Now I am going to be trying out some new Japanese skincare items, and once I've tried them out and once I know that it works, I will make another video on Japanese skincare and actually trying out these items later. Next item is the Senka Perfect Whip, and this is one of the most popular Japanese face washes, and it says up here it's been number one for 8 years running. I've been using this for a long time as well, and I use this especially when I travel because it's really gentle on your face. When I travel, my skin tends to break out a lot more because of the different weather conditions, but this one really helps calm it down. I got a packet of face masks from Lululemon, and this is for 7 days. So these face masks are really popular in Japan, and I want to use this for a video, so I got that. Final skincare item is a Be Festa Bright Up Cleansing Lotion. I've used this a few years ago and it worked really well with removing my eye makeup. Now, the problem with Japanese mascaras is that it works very well, but it's such a pain in the ass to remove because it just stays on your lashes, and I feel that I end up pulling out more lashes, which is not good. So I remembered using this makeup remover and it worked really well, so I'm going to try it out again. So I'm going to try out this product, and if it works really well, I can recommend it to you guys. That is all the items I got in my haul. So it's mainly just Sailor Moon makeup, bunch of skincare, and some Pokemon items. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys haven't yet, check out my top 100 Japanese makeup products. Inside that video, I actually try on all 100 items so you guys can actually see what it looks like when you apply it. So I'll link that video down below. Make sure you check that out. Please thumbs up this video if you love Japanese makeup. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. And also subscribe to my vlog channel to keep up to date with me and what's happening with my life. Follow my social media, which I will link down below. And also let me know down below what other videos you want me to make, because I'm going to try and upload a lot more videos this year for you guys. Thank you so much guys for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!